Here to tell you about an evil agenda that has been going on in my neighborhood for years to get me moved. Because I did drugs in the privacy of my own home. My neighbors have chosen to use and abuse my mental illness diagnosis of addiction to create, with the police's help, a diagnosis of schizophrenia that is not present. There were imposters that came into the neighborhood in July 2019, and I've tried my hardest to get the police to realize this, and I have the evidence that it's true, but they still refuse to help, and instead project what my neighbor Patty Ryan wants, which is me removed from the neighborhood and my home forever. She wants to steal my freedom away. I picked up this book, Writing Freedom, at a little library in the neighborhood, and I just want to read you the introduction, because it mirrors my life. In the beginning, in the mid-1800s, when the East was young and the West was yet to be settled, a baby was born named Charlotte. When she was nothing more than a bundle, she surprised her parents and puzzled the doctors by surviving several fevers, kind of like I've survived several hospitalizations. Folks said that any other baby would have died, but Charlotte was already strong, and I've come out of my hospitalizations in 10 days or less. She talked before most babies babbled, and she never cried, unless someone took something away from her. I don't complain about anything unless my freedom is taken away. And it has been. A few months after Charlotte's second birthday, on a blustery evening, she rode with her parents toward their small farm in the New Hampshire countryside. Their horse-drawn wagon was rickety and swayed back and forth with each gust of wind. Thunder made the horses skittish, and they reared and struggled in their harnesses. Charlotte sat up straight in her mother's lap, just like I stand up to my neighbors, watching the trees waving in the wind and listening to the horses' loud whinnies, because my neighbors are still whinnying that I'm mentally ill when I'm not. Her father tried to settle the team, and her mother held Charlotte snugly and sang a song to comfort her. But Charlotte wasn't afraid, just like I'm not afraid to stand up to my neighbors who have ruined my life. A crack of lightning lit up the countryside, and the horses lurched forward, reeling down the road out of control. "Hold on!" yelled her father. "Stop!" screamed her mother. "Keep them straight! Keep them straight!" Charlotte's mother clutched her closer and tried to hold on as the frantic horses dragged the wagon over the bumpy road. Her father hollered, "Whoa, whoa!" But the horses had already lunged down the steep hill, crowded with trees and boulders. Tree limbs smacked the horses, frightening them even more. The wagon followed, plunging over the side and smashing into tree trunks before it overturned on a rocky ledge. Charlotte was thrown free of the splintered wagon and landed in a bed of tall grass. Her father and mother were instantly killed. Unharmed, Charlotte waved to the snuffling horses, who were now free of the wagon. Like nursemaids, they hovered over her, kind of like angels have hovered over me. At times they whinnied, as if calling for help, kind of like they have presented themselves in the neighborhood. Rain drenched the countryside, and Charlotte shivered through the night. but the horses stood close by, protecting her from the rain and nuzzling her with their warm breath. The horses were still keeping watch over Charlotte when neighbors found her the next morning. She was holding so tight to one of the horses' reins that they didn't dare pry it out of her hand. The old doctor, who had known Charlotte since she was born, wasn't at all surprised that she survived the crash. Instead of taking the horse's reins out of Charlotte's hands, he cut the leathers well above the grip. "She might as well have something to hold on to," he said. "She hasn't got much else. There's no other family to speak of. Kind of like I've lost everything in my life. And I have no support from anybody. Because they believe the doctors. And the doctors believe that my story is not true. Because the police refuse to follow up on the leads of real crime that I've presented." The doctor looked up at the people who had found her. "We got enough mouths to feed," said the man, and he and his wife turned away. "I hate to think you'll grow up in an orphanage," the doctor said as he carried Charlotte. "Kind of like many people think I'm destined to live in an institution." "But if anybody can make it alone in this world, it's you. Since the day you were born, you've been determined as a mule and tough as a rawhide bone." "I will get justice to be served. Some people are doing some extremely illegal activity. And they're calling something something else and think that that's okay. And they're trying to get something to happen so that I move. I need this addressed. I need it stopped. And people need to believe the truth that I have in 911 recordings and on documents that prove negligence by the Division of Police in Columbus, Ohio. They call my claims delusional beliefs, yet I have proof. The reason they don't investigate is to protect the woman who has said the most amount of lies. Patty Ryan, my neighbor, who has tried to get the addict out of the neighborhood, discriminating against me, violating my civil rights for years to get what she wants, calling it something else. Please help me. I need a lawyer immediately to sue the police. And I need it now. Because the federal government does not want me talking about my experience of being tortured with their illegal surveillance program of remote neural monitoring. They want to silence me. And there's enough paper documentation to make that happen. My freedom has already been taken away. Freedom of health. And the executive branch has gone too far. I don't want my body invaded. I don't want my home invaded. I don't want my rights trampled on any longer. If those in power choose not to stand up for my rights and defend them, it's going to kick them in the ass. Do the right thing. Because without it, the wrong thing is going to happen. And everybody will lose. Please, if you can help, I need it desperately. Because I can't do it alone. I've tried. For 4 years. And nobody has been willing to help. I will continue to ask help from the people who are responsible for allowing me to report crime. Please visit my journal page, my quest and journey towards getting my freedom restored, tiered justice, equity and equality on Facebook. And please tell your friends, because nobody should be able to take away somebody's rights like this. It's criminal. And the people who are charged with defending my rights have violated them even more. I need your help right now.